derivatives of sine, cosine, and of the exponential function. In this video, I derive the formula. First, derivative of sine equals cosine. Derivative of cosine equals negative of sine. And the derivative of the exponential function is the exponential function itself. A very nice property of the mathematical constant e. The definition of the derivative of a function f at a number x0 is that the derivative f prime at x0 is the limit of the difference quotient f at x0 plus h minus f at x0 divided by h as the quantity h goes to 0. Clearly, we must assume that the limit exists and that it is finite. Next, we recall some basic formula. First, the limit of sine of alpha divided by alpha as alpha goes to 0 is 1. Secondly, e to the x plus y equals e to the x times e to the y for all numbers x and y. And the addition formula for sine says that sine alpha plus beta equals sine alpha cosine beta plus cosine alpha sine beta. Similar addition formula for the cosine function says that cosine alpha plus beta equals cosine alpha times cosine beta minus sine alpha sine beta. In what follows, we use this formula and the definition of the derivative. In what follows, we need to know that limit as h goes to 0 of cosine of h minus 1 divided by h is 0. This limit can be computed in the following way. First of all, cosine of h minus 1 divided by h can be multiplied and divided by cosine of h plus 1. We are interested what happens to this quantity as h goes to 0. Therefore, when h is close to 0, cosine of h plus 1 is certainly different from 0, and we may multiply and divide by it. So we get that cosine h minus 1 divided by h is cosine h minus 1 times cosine h plus 1 divided by h times cosine of h plus 1. Now cosine of h minus 1 times cosine of h plus 1 is cosine squared minus 1. And this cosine squared of h minus 1 is negative of sine squared of h. So we conclude that the quantity cosine of h minus 1 divided by h can be rewritten as minus sine squared of h divided by h times cosine h plus 1. So we have this rewriting, and this can be grouped as negative sine of h times sine of h divided by h times 1 divided by cosine of h plus 1. This is just the previous expression written slightly differently. But now we know that the limit of sine of h divided by h as h goes to 0 is 1. The limit of sine of h as h goes to 0 is 0. And the limit of cosine of h as h goes to 0 is 1. Therefore, the limit of this product as h goes to 0 is minus 0 times 1 times 1 half. But this is 0. So we have concluded that this limit of the expression cosine of h minus 1 divided by h as h goes to 0 is 0. A result needed just. The derivative of sine is cosine. To prove this result or this formula that derivative of sine d sine of x dx equals cosine of x, we use the definition of the derivative. That is, we compute the limit of the difference quotient sine at x plus h minus sine at x divided by h as h goes to 0. To this end, we first use the addition formula for the sine function, and we observe that this sine at x plus h is sine at x times cosine at h plus cosine at x times sine at h. So we get that sine at x plus h minus sine at x divided by h is sine x cosine h plus cosine x sine h minus sine x, and all that divided by h. In the numerator, we may take sine of x as the common factor of the terms sine of x times cosine of h minus sine of x. So what remains is sine of x times cosine of h minus 1, and then we have the term cosine of x times sine of h. And this sum has now to be divided by h. All right, so we can write this as sine of x times cosine of h minus 1 divided by h plus cosine of x times sine of h divided by h. We know that sine of h divided by h approaches 1 as h goes to 0, and previously we have seen that cosine of h minus 1 divided by h approaches 0 as h goes to 0. We conclude that the limit of this expression is 0 times sine plus 1 times cosine, that is the limit of the difference quotient as h goes to 0 for sine is cosine. This means that the derivative of the sine function is the cosine function. The derivative of cosine is negative of sine. We prove this by similar computation, starting with the difference quotient for the cosine function. That difference quotient is cosine at x plus h minus cosine at x divided by h. And we have to take the limit of this quantity as h goes to 0. To that end, we use the addition formula for cosine and write the numerator as cosine x times cosine h minus sine x times sine h. And then we still had the term negative cosine of x in the numerator. And all this has to be divided by h. The terms cosine of x times cosine of h and negative cosine of x both contain the term cosine of x, which we may take as a common factor. We do that, and we observe that this cosine of x plus h minus cosine of x divided by h becomes just cosine of x times cosine of h minus 1 minus sine of x times sine of h, and this quantity divided by h. We can group these elements as cosine of x times cosine of h minus 1 divided by h minus sine of x times sine of h divided by h. And we have seen that cosine of h minus 1 divided by h approaches 0 as h goes to 0, and sine of h divided by h approaches 1 as h goes to 0. This means that the limit of the difference quotient for cosine is negative sine of x as h goes to 0. And this proves the formula saying that the derivative of cosine is negative sine. The derivative of the exponential function is the exponential function itself. This can be justified or computed by looking at the difference quotient for the exponential function. It is e to the x plus h minus e to the x divided by h. And first we observe that this is the same as e to the x times e to the h minus e to the x, and that difference divided by h. In the numerator, we have two terms with e to the x as a factor in each one of them. We may take e to the x as a common factor, and we get that the difference quotient is e to the x times the quotient e to the h minus 1 divided by h. E to the h is same as e to the 0 plus h, and 1 is same as e to the 0. So we observe that the difference quotient for the exponential function can also be written as e to the x times the quotient e to the 0 plus h minus e to the 0, and that difference divided by h. And next, we observe that the limit of e to the 0 plus h minus e to the 0 divided by h is the slope of the line tangent to the exponential function at x equals 0. The definition of the mathematical constant e was that e is such a number for which this slope equals 1. Therefore, we conclude that the limit of e to the 0 plus h minus e to the 0 divided by h as h goes to 0 is 1. And therefore, the limit of the difference quotient for the exponential function is the exponential function itself as h goes to 0. We have therefore now shown that the derivative of e to the x is the function e to the x itself, a remarkable property of the mathematical constant e. These three formula that we have now derived here must be remembered by heart. Derivative of sine is cosine, derivative of cosine is negative of sine, and derivative of the exponential function is the exponential function itself.